My dear students, welcome to the today's session on salts, what we use in day-to-day life. This is coming under second chapter of 10th class, acids, bases and salts, which is taking more time because every salt we have to study its preparation properties and uses, and in between some other extra information. So we will continue the journey of the second chapter. Still one or two more salts are there. So I welcome for the today's session on the one more important commercial salt, and its common name is bleaching powder. Its formula is CaOCl2. Why? Here two lines are shown. These lines are bonds which are connecting to the calcium. Please refer to the 9th class table. Calcium is +2. Okay. So when it is losing two electrons, it wants two electrons to balance the valency. Therefore, one from OCl, other from Cl, both are -1, -1. Okay. So, because of the satisfaction of the +2, so -2, -1 ions are reacting, so that CaOCl2 is formed. So, the chemical formula for bleaching powder is CaOCl2. Accordingly, it is named as calcium oxychloride. We have seen normal calcium chloride CaCl2. So in between Ca and Cl2, one O is extra. That is called calcium oxychloride, nothing but bleaching powder. Now let us study its preparation property and uses part. Bleaching powder is manufactured using chlorine, which is obtained as one of the products in chlor-alkali process. Please recall chlor-alkali process of sodium hydroxide, where we have obtained hydrogen, sodium hydroxide and the chlorine. All three are industrially very useful. Out of the three, one, that is chlorine, we are taking today to prepare the bleaching powder. How? Let us see. The general chemical formula of bleaching powder, already told, CaOCl2, and its chemical name is calcium oxychloride. Bleaching powder is also known as chloride of lime. So, chloride of calcium is CaCl2. Chloride of lime is Cl2 with CaO. What is lime? Lime is CaO. So, chloride of lime is CaOCl2. That is calcium oxychloride. Nothing but or popularly known as bleaching powder. Now, production, preparation on large scale. When chlorine gas is passed over dry slaked lime, bleaching powder is formed. Preparation is very easy. We have to take slaked lime. Slaked lime is calcium hydroxide. And to get the calcium hydroxide, we have to take the lime, CaO. So bring the lime from the market. Lime is what? Chuna. Chuna ka patthar. Okay. So it is chuna we bring from the market. That we put in the water. That is CaO and H2O. So next day we will get like a butter, soft, white calcium hydroxide, which is known as slaked lime. Slaking is spreading smoothly. That is called slaking. So slaked lime has spreaded. Slaked. That's why it is called as slaked lime. So it is chemically CaOH twice. On that we have to pass chlorine gas. So it will take how much it wants in the structure. Remaining water comes out, and the major product is calcium oxychloride, that is bleaching powder. CaOH twice, that is slaked lime, and we are passing Cl2. So Ca1OCl2. Still 1O and 2H remains, that comes out as water, as the byproduct which escapes to atmosphere, and this will remain, that is taken for the use. Now some properties of bleaching powder. Bleaching powder is a yellowish white solid. Actually, if we take pure bleaching powder, it is white. But this bleaching powder what we use in everyday life, it is not pure. It is commercial bleaching powder. Commercial bleaching powder contains some impurities. That those impurities will give some color. That was specially from the bleaching powder, the chlorine gas is always escaping CO2 gas. That's why whenever you go to bleaching powder bag, just you smell from distant. Don't go close because it is highly irritating. Chlorine gas is highly suffocative and irritating. Therefore, from the distant, if you take the odor of bleaching powder, it smells like chlorine. Why bleach? Sometimes you will ask for the 1 or 2 marks question in the examination. Why bleaching powder smells like chlorine? It is because it is giving continuously chlorine gas to the atmosphere. So that means chlorine gas is coming out of the bleaching powder, or bleaching powder on decomposition gives chlorine gas. So it is due to the chlorine gas present in the bleaching powder and some impurities that give some kind of yellowish color. That's why he says bleaching powder is a yellowish white solid. Bleaching powder is soluble in water, Aram say. Okay, we use in everyday life for the purification. And bleaching powder gives strong smell of chlorine. Here is the reason for this property. Okay, so chlorine is yellowish green, that gives a color to the bleaching powder. Therefore, because of continuously giving chlorine from the bleaching powder, the color of the bleaching powder is yellowish. Otherwise, if you go for the pure, very good quality of the bleaching powder, which is a little bit costly, it is white. But for normal work, for day-to-day work, we don't go for that much purified bleaching powder. So it is slightly yellowish. Now, chemical properties of bleaching powder. When bleaching powder reacts with sulfuric acid, it gives calcium sulfate and chlorine and water. Chemically, it is written like this: calcium oxychloride plus sulfuric acid. Okay. So whenever acid reacts with bleaching powder, corresponding salt is formed. Okay. So I told in the previous class, if you use sulfuric acid, salts formed are sulfates. If we use hydrochloric acid, salts formed are chlorides. And if we use nitric acid, salts formed are nitrates. Depending upon the type of the acid we are using, corresponding salts are formed. Here we are using sulfuric acid, therefore sulfates are formed. Which sulfate? Calcium sulfate. So CaSO4 is formed first, then what is left here? H2 and 1O and Cl2. So these three are the products of action between bleaching powder and sulfuric acid. When bleaching powder reacts with hydrochloric acid, same reaction with sulfuric acid, sulfate, hydrochloric acid, chlorides. Which chloride? Calcium chloride. So this is a similar reaction of this one. Only thing is, here you have changed the acid. See, CaCl2 plus Cl2 plus water. Okay, yeah. Now, solution of bleaching powder is basic in character. This is most important property of the bleaching powder. Why? Bleaching powder in water behaves like a base. Okay, why it is having alkaline nature, basic character? The reason is, strong base is formed when bleaching powder is put in the water. Let us see chemically. When bleaching powder is dissolved in water, it gives two important products. One is calcium hydroxide and hypochlorous acid. One is acid, one is base. But out of the two, hypochlorous acid is a very weak acid. So this is a strong base. Okay. So when a strong base is there, it dominates. Its properties dominates. Therefore, because of the dominance of the base after the reaction, so bleaching powder shows basic character when it is with water. It is because of what? Because of the weak base formed and strong acid formed. Strong acid, strong character dominates. Survival of the fittest. That is the reason. So strongness is there. So that property is carried. instead of formation of an acid in aqueous solution of bleaching powder turns red to blue. This is the basic character. This happens because hypochlorous acid is a very weak acid, I told, while calcium hydroxide is a strong base, that also I told, than the hypochlorous acid. That's why solution of bleaching powder shows basic character. This you have to explain like this in the examination if it comes. In bleaching powder, the word bleach means decolorization. Bleach means to remove the color. Okay, sometimes we remove the color of the hair, sometimes we remove the color of the cloth. So all those are called what? Bleaches, bleaching. And the chemicals which are performing the role of bleaching, they are called what? Bleaching agents. Bleaching powder is a powerful oxidizing agent as it contains chlorine. Thus, because of oxidation, bleaching powder acts as an decoloring agent, whitening agent, and a disinfectant. So here I told, bleaching powder continuously keeps giving the chlorine. So it is because of the chlorine, nascent chlorine comes out from the bleaching powder, that property is taken in water in removing the color, because chlorine removes the color. So it acts as a decolorizing agent or oxidizing agent. Means what? It will oxidize the color material into colorless. So it is also called as oxidizing agent, or it disinfects, because chlorine kills the bacteria and the microbes. So it acts as a disinfectant. So because of the chlorine, it is performing the three different roles.